I'm Stardust. This is Anole Alley. And most of you know the girls, Alice, Holly, and Ellie. We're all going out for the first time on this lovely late fall morning. And as always, we managed to find one of the Anoles out too. It's just a few days after Thanksgiving, and the holidays are now fully upon us. The reason for the seasonal music in this episode. And this is Alice, and today, she's going with me into Anoleland. Alice is one of our oldest dogs. She's 13. She's also an ADBA champion American Pit Bull Terrier. And of course, Ellie and Holly are never far behind. I believe this little fella is Boomer. Well, maybe. There are lots of new hatchlings appearing now. And we've had some cold nights. Temperature is well below freezing, yet there are still Anoles active, proving again how strong and resilient they are to harsh weather. Well, whoever this little Anole is, it's certainly not frightened by Alice. Another thing that I find fascinating and interesting about these little animals, the Anole seems curious as to why she's decided to make herself at home in its territory. While Alice is totally oblivious to its presence. But Alice, however, is in the Anole's world now. The Anole watches her closely. It's fully aware of her. This is the territory where I normally find the female Anole I call Spider, but I haven't seen her today. Well, looks like Alice isn't going anywhere anytime soon. So the little Anole starts assessing the situation. Obviously, Alice is much too large of a target for it to challenge safely. So it decides it's best just to accept her being there for now, since she clearly has lots of backup. Lots of backup. Almost appearing frustrated at all of these trespassers. But the little Anole knows that it's nothing it can do for now. After a while, the Anole decides it's just best to hang out and enjoy the company. It is the holidays, and we might as well get along with all of our neighbors. Enjoying this peaceful, beautiful day. The little Anole even manages to get in some hunting. It manages to catch a small insect for a snack. While Alice enjoys some fun in the sun, the Anole finds this behavior a little disturbing, so it moves over to the bricks to bask. Yes, living on the beautiful Gulf of Mexico can have its advantages. Even the dogs love sunbathing. The Anole moves down a step to improve its chances of catching a fly. Will it be successful? Well, maybe not that particular time. But that's okay, another opportunity soon arises. And that fly is almost as big as the Anole. But he's got it. Aww, but in the process of trying to subdue and kill its prey, the prey gets uncaught. So the Anole will just have to settle for a wing snack instead. Before long, I spot the little Anole I call Starbuck. He's in his usual spot. Then, I see Apollo. He too has survived the cold and is back out hunting on the hutch. They're both growing into beautiful, young, adult Anoles. The Anole, I presume, is Boomer, has now disappeared. But over on the fence, I spot a member of the chain gang. That's one of the 5 or 6 Anoles or more, including Brownie, who live near the chain link fence. And this appears to be one of the adult females. Following my every move is Alice. She's an old girl, and her eyesight is not what it used to be. Again, she doesn't see the Anole, who by instinct has moved to the opposite side of the pole. That's to avoid being spotted. This is a tactic used by Anoles and other tree-dwelling species to avoid being seen and eaten by predators. And apparently, it's worked for them well for millions of years. I hope you guys have enjoyed Alice's trip into Anoleland. Until next time, season's greetings from the Alley.